see no top to deal. Jupiter et
Red Moon. Take one. Teen old brown sweater, I easily mixed with the crowd at Neville Club, a seamy hole. Soon, all but soon, people acoustic me saying such thing as, "We're the charge, man." I'm turning over. All too soon, I notice boys and girls sitting in a hobbled lump, smoking hernia and taking Odeon. I'm getting very high. He had Indian hump. Which he grew in his sleep, smoking hernia, taking Odeon. I'm getting very high. I'm getting very high. Smoking hernia, taking Odeon. I'm getting very high. I'm getting very high.
Thank you. It was 1987. We went in the studio. It was funny. I told Jonathan Briley he could join Sleep Chamber if we could do our version of Sight of Pain, Sight of Pleasure. And he said, yeah. He was dying to be in Sleep Chamber. I mean, Jonathan Briley was a nice guy, gentleman, still, you know, black belt and a bodybuilder and arm specialist and all that shit, black ops, whatever the fuck. He was that, you know, and he was perfect for Sleep Chamber. People would say, you know, you're crazy, but he's insane. So, I mean, Jonathan Briley was perfect in Sleep Chamber. What did we do? We did Sight of Pain, Sight of Pleasure, Kiss the Whip. We did that the same day. And we didn't make too many trips in the studio in 87. Gets expensive. We did Odorata Sexualis the next day. And The Nun, which I thought came out like shit. I don't know. The engineer thought we should do something a little more poppier. And so I wrote The Nun in the studio. I mean, This is the way we used to record. We didn't write songs and practice them and then go record. I wrote all those songs in the studio within an hour. It's funny, spell bondage is much like Submit to Desire. One side's got all your studio stuff from Newbury Sound. Like on Submit, there's Fetish, Subterranean, Subhuman, whatever, all those tracks were done in Newbury's Sound, and the B-side of Submit was all radio broadcasts, you know, when we did something live on the radio, more ambient type instrumentals. That was on the B-side. Spell Bondage, the B-side was, Extreme Unction was done in the studio at Newbury Sound, but the rest of the tracks were just little ditties we had hanging around. Femme Fatale, whatever. That's why it didn't end up on the DVD. It was just a little ditties that we didn't know what to do with. Just filler. What do you want me to say? It was filler. But it did have some good songs. We got Jonathan Briley in the band. I mean, everybody, with Jonathan Briley, the guy has decided he does not want to carry the weight of Sleep Chamber any longer. I mean, he has a family, okay? I don't have a family. You know what I mean? I'm not married, I don't have kids, none of that shit. He does. So, it was getting a little dangerous around the time we were fucking around the clubs, and it was getting crazy. So, I mean, he had to step out. It was serious, he had to step out. It was getting too intense for him. I value those days, though. He's a brother, a blood brother. And, I don't know, Kiss the Whip is Kiss the Whip. We didn't, I didn't see it as any kind of special song, but it did. It became an anthem at the live shows. People loved to sing it. But, you know, there's an important thing about Kiss the Whip. That stands for Sleep Chamber. We are the ultimate minority, okay? And if you don't know what that means, you have no business being around Sleep Chamber, listening to Sleep Chamber, or any of that. And we've decided since the fucking corporations and the government are in the middle of destroying music by making things like Guitar Hero, now people don't idolize or value musicians as being individuals because they can go home and play on their guitar or whatever, be like Aerosmith or AC/DC. But now music's going down, it's dying. The only shit you're gonna hear on the radio is what they want you to hear. We don't give a shit about your fucking radio stations. We don't give a shit about your magazines or any other shit that has to do with rock and roll or the fucking scene. Sleep Chamber has decided to become underground and private. The only exposure people are going to have to Sleep Chamber is if you're dedicated and you prove it. And you know something? I'm going to be fucking crazy enough to show you what I'm going to do. Okay? Keep an eye on the website. Keep an eye on Facebook. Okay? And see how fucking sick and how crazy Sleep Chamber... Oh, no, it's sick and crazy, but... See how individual we are. See how aware we are and what dimension we're interested in being in, okay? Because we don't give a shit about your rock and roll or your fucking bands or who's this or who's that or who's better. Fuck them all, okay? Sleep chamber is the ultimate minority. And if you don't know what that is, pay attention. Look up, brother. It's coming. We don't give a shit about rock and roll or music or scenes, okay? Fuck off.
Goodbye. Mrs. Goodbye. Ah!